Welcome back to The Road Show. This morning in the buzz, paper or plastic? Well, the choice may not be up to you in the near future. Barrington Town Council is set to vote tonight an ordinance that would ban plastic bags from stores and restaurants. If passed, it would be the first ban of its kind in Rhode Island. Under the ban, stores would still be able to use plastic produce, bakery, or deli counter bags. Retailers would be able to charge a 5-cent fee for recyclable paper bags. So, what do you guys think about that?
I like it. I know that it's shakes things up a little bit, and then if you forget to bring in your own bag, you're getting charged 5 cents per paper bag. But I think it's a much safer choice. I mean, the app, when you go out and see all these plastic bags just filling up places and on the ground, you know, we can easily do without it.
Even going to the, you know, about a month or two ago, we went out to the landfill to do a story out there. And inside, you know, where they're actually working and separating stuff, you cannot believe the amount of paper, plastic bags that are used and then just tossed. A lot of them aren't even recycled. So the workers there are constantly sorting through and letting the vacuum suck them up so that they can be recycled.
I can't tell you how many plastic bags. I mean, this is why I like to bag my own groceries sometimes, because I will actually fill an entire plastic bag up, where some people, you sometimes you get home and they're double bagged, and inside are like 3 apples and a bag of popcorn. And you're thinking, why is just this taking up 2 whole plastic bags? So I feel like the waste is definitely there in terms of just, you know, people not using them right. It sounds silly, but, you know, how many times do you come home and you have more plastic bags than you do items? And I feel bad. I mean, I'm definitely guilty that I don't necessarily bring them back, bring all these bags back, and then recycle them. I reuse them, so I'll use them as, like, my bathroom trash bins. But, I mean, I definitely don't recycle them properly, and I think that now I'll kind of be forced, if I go visit Barrington, I'll be forced to use the paper bags, and I'd feel better about it.
I was actually surprised to see that it says now the markets will be able to charge 5 cents for the plastic, because I know some of them are already charging for the plastic. And if you do the self-checkout yourself and you have your own bag, there's a selection on there to say, you know, I have my own bag, so you can hit it, so it'll deduct the money from the, you know, from the plastic.
I think the part where I'll get nervous is if I'm going out to eat somewhere and you get one of those, you know, say you go out for Chinese food and the sauce is coming over the side, I like to have the plastic bag then. So I'll pay, you know, a little extra, because paper sometimes just doesn't soak it up enough.
Now you're at home and you're scrubbing the insides of your reusable bags and you're thinking, why am I going through all this? But I'm wondering, you know, a lot of times when you go to those wholesale food stores as well, they give you everything in, you know, the cardboard boxes, the leftover cardboard boxes, or nothing at all. You're just taking it from your carriage and putting it into your car, and then you just take out each item separately. So I'm kind of surprised that it's taken this long for something like a plastic bag ban to happen.
And, you know, I know they've also asked people, you know, when they are using the plastic bags, if they're going to recycle them or if they just, you know, toss them in their one of their bins, to make sure you tie them too. Because the wind, if you go to the landfill, the wind picks these things up, and they are all over the place. The, you know, the animals that are around there, you know, they get tangled up in the trees. They get, you know, you can't even imagine how much damage they do to the environment.
I'm interested to see if other cities and towns in Rhode Island now pick this up as well. If this does go through tonight, because they are voting tonight in Barrington, if this goes through, if other cities will decide to do it.
I'm sure
they will. I mean, it's for a great cause. And like you mentioned before, you know, they get blown around. I've seen some interesting pictures, too, that looks like a jellyfish moving in the water. Really, it's plastic bags.
Well, then animals eat it, and that's the sad thing.
And they all, you know, they also talk about how it, you know, backs up storm drains if it goes down, and what, you know, a lot of people don't realize what havoc these plastic bags cause and how long they're around, and they don't break down very easily at all.
That's why I think a lot of people are wondering, well, this is the first? This is the first town that's trying to do this? It's kind of shocking.
And if I forget to bring a reusable bag, I will. I'll pay the 5 cents, the 10 cents, whatever it ends up being, you know, depending on how many bags I need.
Or just load everything into your arms and just
carry
it all out together.
I think that's the easiest
balancing act.
Yeah, that way you can separate it yourself. You don't have to worry about, you know, 3 plastic bags in the in the grocery bag. So, tough thing.
Big changes might be coming along.
See how they vote tonight, too.
Well, people were putting their vote on our Facebook wall, and TJ Harris, he thinks it's a fantastic idea, and they should do the same with plastic water bottles, too.
Oh, maybe they will.
And this may be the start, TJ.
And Lily Spencer, she tells us that, I think this should be statewide. That would get some attention from the nation. Wouldn't that be interesting if Rhode Island was the first state?
Let's try and do it.
And Jen Mahoney Barrard says, ban them nationwide. Those things are terrible. Then we can get started on other kinds.